So now we're on the module 15 of our SRWE course, the IP static routing. Okay. So in the last video we talked about the routing concepts. Now for the IP static routing. Like I forgot the module 14. Okay. So now for the module 15, the IP static routing. Okay. So in this module, so the objective of this module is okay. So the configuration of IPv4 and IPv6 static routes. So we have here 5 topics in this module. We have the static routes. So we need to describe the command syntax for static routes. Configure IP static routes. The IP and IPv4 and V6. The IP default static routes, okay, also for IPv4 and V6, we'll configure it. Configure floating static routes, so we'll be differentiating this later on. And then the static host, configure static host routes, okay, also for V4 and V6. So static host routes that direct traffic to specific hosts, so directly on the device. So static routes, we have types of static routes. So we have the standard static route. So I think this is the common static route that you configure the routing from a router to another interface of a router. Right? We also have the default static route. So default with the if there is no specific route on the routing table, so we use the default static route. Then the floating static route. So this is the backup backup static route, okay, to the main static route. Then summary static route. So I think, so I read this last night, but I don't see this summary static route. Or I think this is the full configured or full configured static route. With the next hub address and the next exit interface. Okay, the next hub options, we have the next hub route, directly connected static route, and fully specified static route. I think this is the summary static route. I don't think the full stuff. For the next hub route, so only the next hub IP address is specified. This type of route, you can only see the next hub IP address, the interface. Then the directly connected static route, the router exit interface. So for example, the serial link, the serial interface, or gigabit interface. You also have fully specified static route. So both next hub address and router exit interface are specified. So for the configuration of IPv4 static route, so have the IP route, so the network address that you want. The network address of the network, then the subnet mask. So we can also configure the next hub address, so next hub IP address, the exit interface, so like I said, so serial interface, and then the distance. This is for the floating static route, so this is used for administrative distance. Okay. So we will be discussing that later on this on the video. So for the parameter, the network address. Okay. This is the destination IPv4 network address. Okay. The remote network to add to the routing table. The subnet mask. So identifies the subnet mask of the network address, the IP address, the next hub router IP address, and the exit interface. So the exit interface to forward packets. So it creates a directly connected static route. It's typically used in point-to-point configuration wherein there is only two routers on the two devices, which is the routers on the network. So exit interface, IP address, this is the fully specified static route, as you can see. The distance, it is the administrative distance. It is used for configuring a floating static router. We'll be discussing that later on. for the IPv6 static route command, so it's also the same. Instead for this, we use the IPv6 instead of IP only. The IPv6 route, the prefix and the prefix length. So this is the IPv6 prefix. This is the network address of the IPv6 address. The length, this is the subnet mask. The IPv6 address, or the next hub address, next hub IPv6 address, the exit interface, so which is also exit interface. What? IPv6 address. Okay, you can also add the IPv6 address for fully specified. And then the distance or administrative distance, we also configure this on the IPv6 static route. So it's also the same. So IPv6 prefix, this is the destination network address, the subnet mask, so the prefix length for the IPv6, the next hub router IPv6 address, the exit interface, the forcefully specified, and this administrative distance. We also use the IPv6 unicast router. Okay. So must be configured to enable the router to forward IP path. So I think for IPv4 is, I think it's default IP routing. To explicitly configure it, IP routing. Let's see. IP routing command. We also use this command. Hot name is static route. Okay. There's also a packet tracer for module 15. I think we will be doing that later. So we have, so the next module is the last module of the SRWE. So this is short. Okay. So we done with the 29 packet tracers. So the 415 we have the 30th, and then for 16 we have the 31st. So on our 31st, we don't we still don't do the lab activities, so I think we will be doing that. Okay, so dual stack topology. So for dual stack topology is, there's a IPv4 and IPv6 address. And this topology is, currently no static routes are configured. Okay, now we will be configuring it. So we have the IPv4 routing table, then R2, R3. Let's see, just examine our router 1. Okay, router 1. So we have, so this network is variably submitted. So this network, so 7.7.2.16.2. So we have here the network address. So it is directly connected. Okay. Then the local, so it is the interface. This is the, I think this is the default gateway, the static route, so which is the 172.16.2.1 we have here. It is connected to this network. It's just a local static route, so it is the IP, no, this is the default gateway, I think. Commonly this is the default gateway. Okay, it is connected to this port. Serial 0/1. We also have the 3.0/24. This is the network. It is connected. We have here the 172.16.3.1. We have this, the local static route, and then it is connected through this interface. Okay, as you can see, it's local static route. Okay. So IPv6 starting route. Start. Skip that. So R1 can ping R2. But R1 cannot ping R3 because we don't have routing information to get to this router 3. So none of the routers have knowledge of any networks beyond directly connected interface. This means each router can only reach directly connected networks as demonstrated in the following ping test. So we can ping this, but R1 cannot ping R3. So how can we ping that? We use the static route, right, to this network. we manually configure the static route to go to the RT. So in this module, we don't configure the dynamic routing. Okay. Only do the static routing. For IPv6, it's still the same. So we have the connected local host. Okay. R1 can ping, R2 and R1. It's just version 6. Okay. Check your understanding, which two methods can be used to identify the next hop in the static route. Next hop. Transit interface. Destination IP address. Okay. This is the next hop IP address. And then this is the exit interface, the interface of the router, the egress port. So which IPv4 static route statement is true? But we have using exit interface only. Let's see. Wildcard mask. We also have the wildcard mask. Let's see, wildcard. This is, I think this is the inverted subnet mask. Specify range of network addresses. Wildcard mask. How is the destination IP? I'm so tired. V6 static route identified. Using prefix and prefix line. Okay. So IPv4 next static route. Let's see. Three modules. Okay, let's do this fast. So next hub static route. Okay, this is for configuring IP static routes. So IPv4 next hub static route. So we use the, so in this next hub static route, we use the next hub IP address. So as you can see, we have this IP route. So this is the command for routing, so for static routing. The network address, so for example, we have the R1. So 172.16.1. So this one here. So we cannot go to this network, so we need a static route to go to this network. So because only these networks can be accessed by 2.0, okay, because this network can only be accessed by the router, so we must configure the static route for us to communicate with other networks or send packets to the other networks. So IP route, the network address. So on the R1, we need this. So the remote networks here are this one. So 1, 2, and 3. Okay, the subnet mask of this network. And then the, I think this is the ingress port. Okay. So 172.16.2.2. We have here in this one, ingress port. So for us to go with that network or communicate with that network, we need to go to this port, not this. Okay. So this is the exit interface. This is the next hub address. Okay. So also we have the 192.26.1.1.0.1.0. So this network here. So we will also use this ingress port. Also for the RT. Now for the routing table of R1, after the configuration, you can see the, here the S, so it indicates the static route. So the administrative distance, the metric, those via this interface, right? So for the next hop, static hops also the same. So first we need to first we need to configure the unicast routing for us to enable the routing of IPv6 packet. We have the command, the IPv6 route, the network prefix, IPv6 prefix. So this is the network address, and then the subnet mask or prefix length for IPv6. And then which interface will it go to? So 2.2. For example, we have 2 and 2. So for the IPv6 route, so this is the routing table. So it's also the same source code. So S for static, C for connected. We also have the IPv4 directly connected static route. So the difference between this and the last one is, in this directly connected static route, we use an interface, the exit interface. So let's see. So it's the same for R1, the configuration for R1. So for us to go to this network or remote network, so 172.16.10, the subnet mask. So we use R1 using the exit interface. The exit interface of the R1, the S0/1/J. So for the next hub address, we use the ingress port, the ingress IP address of the R2, which is 172.16.2.2. So for the directly connected static route, we use the exit interface of our router. So also this is the right routing table of R1. So it is directly connected, even if it's not really connected. So we have here the note, using an XHub address is generally recommended. So directly connected static routes should only be used with point-to-point serial interfaces. For example, we have here the R1 and here with the R1. Okay, serial interfaces. Just for serial interfaces. So directly connected. Support for our IPv6 is also the same. Our command, the IPv6 route, the network, the IPv6 network address, IPv6 prefix, the subnet mask or the prefix length, and then the exit interface. So for a fully specified static route, we use the next hub address and the exit interface. For example, so IP route, the network address, the subnet mask. So this is the exit interface. For example, we have the R1, so G0/0/1, and then the next hub address. It's too easy, right? No, it's easy to comprehend, right? See, also our routing table. So via, we have this next hub address, and then the exit interface. For IPv6 fully specified static route, so it's still the same. Wait. Okay. Use the link local address for IPv6. Wait. So in fully specified IPv6 static route, both the exit interface and the next hub IPv6 address are specified. There is a situation that IPv6 when fully must be used. So if the IPv6 static route uses an IPv6 link local address as the next hub address, use fully specified static route. Okay. So as you can see here, we have here on the first configuration, we use the link local address of the another router as the next hub address, but interface has to be specified for link local next hub. So if we are using the next hub address, the link local address as our next hub address, we need to specify the exit interface on our router. Okay, so that's it. So IPv4 router table, link local address, and the, so I think the link local address, that's it, IPv6. So if you are confused, IPv6 link local, so I think this is the layer 2 address of IPv6. Purpose ba? Particular PC link. This is just for links, some local links. Okay. So verify static route. So we use this following show commands to show IP route static, show route network, and show running config section IP route. Okay, so display only IPv6 static routes. So we use the show IP route static. So we use the filter begin here. Show IP route static. Show only static routes. Specific IPv4 network. So we show IP route. And then this is, I think this is the interface. Okay. IPv4 static route configuration. Okay, for all the, if we need to show our configuration for static routes, we need to enter this command, show running config section IP route. So it's the same with IPv6. So on show commands of IPv6, the only difference is we use the keyword show IPv6. Okay. IP route, this is the network, and then the show run config. So it's our configuration for the static routes for IPv6. Okay, syntax checker, configure a static route. Okay. So I think we don't need this topology because we have a guide here. So configure IPv4 next up static router. So we're IPv4, so we just need IP route. Then this network 192.168.2.0, the subnet mask, and then using the next up address, so 192.168.1.1. Okay, figure a full specified static route. So we need the exit interface. So using exit interface, so IP route 172.168.3.0, then 255. Our exit interface is 0/0/1. Then our next sub address. 2.1. Okay. So for the IPv6, so we use the IPv6 route. Then our address. So cafe 2/64. So our next up address would be 01 GB8 cafe 1. Hey. So we need to specify the fully specified IPv6 route. So IPv6 route. Just need to copy this. Then our, so we use the link local address. Okay. Okay. Exit configuration and use the command to display only IPv4 static routes in the routing table of R2. So we use the show IP route. Okay, we use the static routes to show IP route. Static. So use the command to display only IPv6 static routes. So we have IPv6 route static. So you are now logged in to RTIP. Wow. So configure the directly connected. So IP route. 172.16.3.0. We have 2.5.0 and then 0/5. Need for directly connected. Okay, so IP route. 172.16.1.0.2.5.0 then 0/1. Fully specified. I will also, this is the only difference is 8.2, then IPv6 route. I have this network using this interface. Okay. Oops. We need to lowercase this. Directly connected, so IPv6 route. Our IPv6 network address. No, the prefix and length. And then also this one. Too many. Exit. So show IP route. Static. So show IPv6. Route static. So we have successfully configured and verified this V4V6 static routes. So configure IP default static routes. I think the only difference here is, let's see, the only discussion is the default static routes. Okay. So default, this is the most, this is the common definition of the default route. This is a static route that matches all the packets. So instead of routers storing routes for all the networks in the internet, they can store a single default route to represent any network that is not in the routing table. Okay, let's see if we can have. So it can be locally learned or configured locally or learned from another router. Okay. So it does not have far left bits to match between the default route and destination IP address. Okay, so it is used when no other routes in the routing table match the destination IP address of the packet. So if a more specific match does not exist, then the default route is used as the gateway of last resort. Okay, so it is used when connecting an router to service provider network or the internet or a stub router. So it's typical that static route scenario. So R1 only needs to know about directly connected networks. So for all the other networks, we can use default static route pointing to R2. So all the packets that you receive, just send it to R2. So it doesn't matter if what network or as a specific network, it just a default route sent to R2. Okay, the syntax for IPv4 is similar except to the network address is all the zeros and the subnet mask is all the zeros. Okay, so these zeros in the route will match any network address. It's also referred as quad zero route. So we have the static default static route, the IP route, this is the network address. This is the subnet mask, the IP address, or the exit interface. Right? The next up IP address or the exit interface. So the default static route for IPv6 is the same. Just we use this :// 0. So this is all 0 for network prefix or IPv6 prefix. And the prefix length is 0. So it does not need to match all the bits. So it is 0/0. Configure default static route. So it's the same. So 0/0, so all the zeros, and then the next up address. Also with this IPv6 route, we use this :// 0 and the next up address. Do it. You can. I know you can understand this, even though I will not. explicitly explained it. So IP route for example for R1, so IP route the network 2.172.16.2.2. So this interface. So all the packets we receive just send it to R2. So for verifying IPv4 static route, show IP route static. So you can see the asterisk here. So this is the, I think this is the candidate for default static route. So this network via this next hub IP interface. Also the same with IPv6. Okay. So task checker. So configure an IPv4 step, default static route in R3 to reach all nodes. Use the next hub IPv4 address. So now we are on the R3. To reach all remote networks, use the next hub IPv4 address. So the next hub would be this 192.168.1.2. Okay, so IP route. So 0.0. Then 192.168.1.2. IP route. Should be IP route. So for IPv6, so we use the IPv6 route, the :\0, and then use this 201db8cafe1.2. DB8 cafe 2. So it should be 1. Okay. So exit. So for route, so show IP route. Static. Static routes. Show IPv6 static route. Show IPv6 route static. Sorry. So we have successfully configured verified default routes. So configure floating static routes. So the main difference is we configure the IP route configuration command with administrative distance. Okay, for example here, so we're gonna have so in the last few modules, so we have the administrative distance for example for the dynamically route. For example, we have the EIGRP, so we have the administrative distance of 90 for it's OSPF. We have the 110 administrative distance. So in configuring floating static routes, we use the administrative distance to wait. So if the floating static route is configured with the the floating static routes are used to provide backup path to the primary or dynamic route. Okay, so in the event of link failure, the floating static route is only used when the primary route is unavailable. So to accomplish this, so it's configured with higher administrative distance from the primary route, because so when we configure the static routes, it uses the low. It prefers the lower administrative distance. So for the floating static routes, we configured it with higher administrative distance than the primary route. So in case of there's a link that is in case there's a failed link, so we can use the floating route. So for example, we have here in the branch router, so I used to reach the HQ router here using the private one link. So for for example, it is this so it is a static route, or for example, it is a dynamic route. It is used on dynamic routing. So for example, we have the OSPF. So it has the administrative name distance of 110. So for the floating static route, so we have the, for example, we have the higher administrative distance configured. So we have 110 or higher. So however, if that link ever fails, so this link here, so I can use a floating static route connecting to the internet as a backup. So if this link fails, so we use this link with the higher administrative distance. You see, so this is the configuration for IPv4 and IPv6 floating static route. Okay, if we don't specify the administrative distance in an IP route, in our configuration of IP route, so the administrative distance of that is 1. So for example, in this configuration, we have the IP, the administrative distance of 1. We also specify the floating static route, so we use the higher administrative distance of 5 than 1. So we talk about that the prepared route is the more the lower administrative distance. So we use this as the primary route, and this is just a backup route. So if this route fails, we use this floating route. Okay. Same with the IPv6. So this we have the default static route. This is the next up address. Then the administrative distance. Okay. So IP route static. So I think we just verify the default route R2R is started. Note that IPv4 floating static route to R3 is not present in the routing table. Okay. Let's see. Okay, we don't see the floating static route if we use the show IP route static. But if we use the show run, for example, we see our configuration for IPv4 and V6 floating static route. So for testing the floating static route, so in this example, we shut down these links here. Okay. For up R2, the serial links. And then, so as you can see on R1, automatically generates messages. So indicating that serial interface to R2 is down. So show IP route static. So we can see now that the floating static default routes are now installed as the default routes and are pointing to R3. Okay, via 10.10.2. Okay, use this. So we now use this link. Syntax checker. Hi. So IPv4 static route. Default static route. So IP route. It is default. The next sub address would be 90.168.1. Okay. Now this is the floating default static route. So IP route 0.0. Then the next up is 10.10. We use this link with the administrative distance of 5. Now for the IPv6, IPv6 route. Zero, the next up address. For IPv6, so IPv6 route. So insert configuration display, IPv4 route link. So IP show, IP route. You can see the floating configure verify floating static accounts. Oh no! Dot verify. So configure floating static routes. So for host routes, so for the host routes, let's see, automatically installed host routes. So this means that when we configure the interface of a router, so that is the local host routes, okay. So the local routes for the interface are installed. Okay, as you can see here, 198.51.100.0.1. Okay. For branch, we have here that one. So this is the automatically local routes. Okay, when we configure the interface. Okay. Static host routes. So for the static host routes is manually configure static route to direct traffic to specific destination device such as server shown in the figure. So I think we have the configuration. We have the IP route. This is the address of the server. Okay. So we also use this broadcast destination address. I think the static route is destination IP address. And the okay, /32 mask. Okay. /28.4 IPv6. Okay. So we use this. It is used. And then this is the, I think this is the interface. 192. This is the next sub IP address. 198.51.100.2. So through this port here. So the same for the IPv6. So we use the, this is the address of the router, the server here, and then the /128, and then the next hub address. Okay, we can also verify the static host routes by show IP route, and then show IPv6 route. So configure IPv6 static host route with local next hub. Okay, we use the local address for SI next hub address. So however, you must specify interface type and interface number when using local link local address as the next hub. So we talked about that earlier. So first, the original IPv6 static host route is removed. We need to remove the static route. I think this is the next hub, I think. Oh, /28. Yes, first the original IPv6 static host route. Let's see. Okay, we remove this one because we will using the link local address as our next hub. Okay, so we need to remove this. And then if we are using our, like I said, so like we are discussing earlier, when we are using the link local address as our next up address, we need the exit interface of the router, right? /0/0/1/0. Okay. So configure and verify static host routes based on the specified requirements. Okay, displays the routing table on branch router. Okay. Show IP route for our IPv4, for IPv6, or IPv6 route. So enter global configuration mode. So configure, turn on. Static route to a host. So we have this one. IP route. Then our destination IP address. Exit interface of 0/1/0. Okay. For the IPv6, okay, so IPv6 route, WSD interface. So I think we need to specify B238 because this is our server IPv6 address slash, and then our exit interface. So S0/1/0. I think we will be using our Alink local address IPv6. We will be using our local address. Let's see. F0FEAT. FEAT. I don't follow it. Okay. What? Okay, it must have the 128. Okay, so I think this is a bug. Okay. So as you can see, we have here the slash 28. So how can we know the prefix? Okay, so we need to exit. Show IP route and show IPv6 route. Okay. Configure the static host routes. Okay. So module practice and quiz. Okay, we have already downloaded this path tracer. Configure IPv4, IPv6 and default routes. So we'll be doing that after this video. Okay, now. Later. Then what did I learn this module? I know you learned a lot. So static routes, configure IP static routes, default, we'll not discuss this anymore. This is just a summary. Static routes, okay? Configure IP static routes. We learned how to configure it. So just IP route, then the network address, the subnet mask for IPv4, the IP, then the next up IP address or the exit interface or fully specified IP next up and exit interface. Okay, for the IPv6 we have the IPv6 route, the IPv6 prefix, the length, the next up IPv6 address, the exit interface. That's it. So IP default static routes, so the only difference is we use the address of 0.0, the 4 zeros, the quad zero. So we also use that for default static routes. Configure floating static routes. We just configure a backup IP route with higher administrative distance. So configure static host routes. So we use the address of the specific device. Then we use the 32-bit mask, so the subnet mask, and for IPv4. For V6, we use the 128-bit mask, and then the next up address or the exit interface. Okay. So module quiz. So the next would be the troubleshooting. So these are the last module. So one, the network that configures maybe command IP route. What's the purpose of this command? So just to provide a route format for which there is no route in the routing table, because this is a default static route. So which interface static route is uses only exit interface. We use the directly connected static route. Okay, the network administrator uses the command IP route. Okay, floating static route. So remove from routing, even though error is still functioning, because the administrative distance, okay? There is no administrative distance, it should be 1, okay? It is the, if you don't specify this, the administrative distance, it is 1, so So obviously it will be the primary route, because the IRGP we have the 90, so one is lesser than 90, so we use the static route as our primary route. So what type of static route is created in the next, when the next hub IP address and everything has specified? We have this fully specified. We have the next hub address and exit interface. So correct syntax for floating static route. We have the administrative distance. So which state static route statement shows a recursive IPv6 route. So for the IPv6 static route, see, we only use the next hub IP address. Okay. So in this example, we use this one. Okay. So network administrator is configuring a route to forward packets to the specific web server. So it should be a host route. No. Specific web server or a default route. No, it's web server, so a host route. Okay. So which command would create? Oh! Wait! Bakit? Wait lang, patapos na ako! So which command would create a valid IPv6 default route? This one. Number 9 na ako eh. So what is characteristic of default static route? Okay. So what is the purpose of floating static route? Alternate serve as a backup route to dynamic route. So OSPF we have 110. What commands we use to determine the, so we have to shut down those. Uses distance parameter, we have the floating. To be used as backup route, and then we have this. Let's check. So we all got correct answers. So my brother calling me. So that's it.